Last semester, I guided this student through Organic Chemistry 1 by giving her complete access to Chemmunity and having multiple study sessions. Now it's time to find out what grade she got. All right, moment of truth.
Uh-huh.
What did you get in Organic Chemistry 1 this semester?
I ended with a B.
Yay! Yes. Okay, that's great. I know that you wanted the A.
Yeah.
Who doesn't want the A starting off? You got a B.
I know.
In a difficult class.
In a hard one. It's true.
Okay.
Yeah.
How do you feel about it?
I'm happy I did it. I was really nervous, I think, at the end because I didn't do great on my, almost last exam and then, my final I was nervous about.
Yeah.
So I am happy that I didn't, drop, as much as I thought I was going to, if that makes sense. So
going into the final, what grade did you have?
I had, I think, a B+.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it was I was either going to get up or go down,
yeah.
It was one of those but the thing is that the final is weighed really heavy. So if you tank the final, then it'll drop you a whole letter grade. So I was I don't want to drop a whole letter grade. You know what I mean?
Right.
So yeah, that's what I was most nervous about.
Cause you took the ACS final.
Mm-hmm.
How was that?
The best I've done in all of them.
Really?
I had ACS
okay.
Gen Chem 1 and 2, and I didn't do great on those. And this time around, it was hard. There were some really random questions that they threw in
mm-hmm.
that weren't at all expected. They weren't
okay.
on any practice I'd done. They weren't even on the books, practice problems, mm. super out of the blue. But I left there and I was way more confident. I was okay, I knew that this one was right. Even when I was kind of narrowing it down mm-hmm. and being it's between these two, I knew I was narrowing it down to the right ones. So I felt good about that.
Okay.
Pretty confident.
Yeah.
So not too bad.
And clearly you didn't do too bad
because
you ended with
bad.
A B.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Thankfully that did not tank your grade.
Yeah, uh-huh.
And then we're moving into the next semester with a bit more knowledge
right,
and not feeling like you don't remember anything.
Yeah, true.
Looking back, what would you do differently this time around?
I think preparing before class a little bit more because I think I have a better idea of how that would look like mm-hmm. now that I've done it. And I think I thought I was preparing before class, but now looking back, I'm no, I could have definitely looked at up topics a little bit more, looked at definitions and gone to class with questions instead
okay.
of having questions come up during class, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Constantly staying ahead because I would finish the exam and then be like, okay, have a week break and then I'll keep studying. But I think mm-hmm. Realistically, as much as that would be so nice, I think just taking that time to just jump right in and getting ready for the next exam,
yeah.
Having that mentality, I think that's probably what I'm going to do this next semester, stay ahead
okay.
and prepare before class, really do whatever it is, but a few hours before class or what, that's my goal. So
okay, because you were watching Chemmunity videos,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
and I know that wasn't necessarily every single time watching mm-hmm. before your class started. So
mm-hmm.
that can be a great way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now prepping for this next round to
yeah.
do that, to help with definitions and to just get a glimpse of what you're going to be learning in class.
Right.
Now, do you feel like you gave your 100% all semester long?
No.
Why not?
I think I just got burnt out pretty quick this last year, spring and summer, I did school the whole time.
Yeah.
And then I jumped in the fall and I jumped right into Ochem and I just was already fried by September.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I got discouraged because I didn't do as great as I wanted to on the first exam. So I just kind of got bummed. And I was taking a lot of hard classes at the same time. So I was giving all my attention to Ochem.
Yeah.
And then my other classes were suffering. So mm-hmm. I have to, put effort into that after the exam to really get ready for the exams. And every single exam this semester, all of them happened at the same week and a half. Time management on my end, I definitely could have done better on, but I think I just kind of really struggled with putting 100% in all my classes, and I was kind of doing 80% in Ochem,
yeah.
20% in this one, 10% in this one, and then when things got easier in Ochem, I was okay, I can go to 40% in Ochem
mm-hmm.
and amp it up on these ones. So I think that was something I definitely got to practice because realistically, that's the hard part, I feel in college in general,
yeah.
Just really balancing everything out and then everything outside of school too, So yeah, I think I could have done better, started stronger and kept the momentum for sure. I definitely recognize I didn't do great on that. So
what would your 100% going into this semester look like?
I think if I keep ahead
mm-hmm.
no matter what, even if I fall behind, I'm not behind. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And I think that's what got me this last semester because then I'd be the day that the homework is due and I'm still doing the homework. My goal the entire semester when I started was to submit everything 2 days before.
Yeah.
And I could have done it. I totally could have. But I think it's just time management. If I can sit down every week and schedule out what I need to do that week or schedule what I need to do that month and then like every week like reevaluate, I think I'd be way more on top of it. So like when the next month comes around, I have an exam like the first week, I'm like, okay, I'm going to do my homework 2 weeks in advance. Mm-hmm. Then I have like a week and a half to study.
Right.
And like time manage, that's my weakness in a lot of things in my life. So I need to practice that. That's for sure.
Yeah, okay. So. Hey, I mean, this is the perfect time to,
right,
to
yeah.
like see that.
It's true. New year, know? New me, new semester.
It's that. It's yeah, that. Yes.
It works out.
It's that. And then it's also great to see that before you start dental school, before, mm-hmm. you know, you decide really any of that. Mm-hmm. And even post-grad life, you're going to constantly be doing time management.
Uh-huh.
This is forever with you, not just, you know,
totally,
school.
Totally.
So seeing that now is definitely going to help you with mm-hmm. the next semester. This class typically will stop people from continuing on in their major.
It is. It's a weed out course. Mm-hmm. It's really heartbreaking. Yeah, it's sad. That's true.
But hey, you did it. I'm proud of you. Honestly, I'm so proud of
Yay,
you.
Yay, we did it.
We did it. We got you through it. We have a whole nother semester to, again, try to get that A again. You've learned a lot.
Mm-hmm.
You know that getting ahead, watching those videos before going into class,
mm-hmm.
we keep with the practice problems. We keep with that momentum
yeah.
and keep trying to stay ahead in time management. And you'll do well. I have no doubt.
I feel good this yes. semester. We're going to get it. It's going to work out.
Even though RA got a B, it's still possible for you to get an A in organic chemistry. If you don't believe me, I reached out to students who used Chemmunity last semester and received so many emails sharing that they got the A. But look, I know that not everyone is going to get an A, and that's okay. If you didn't get the grade you wanted, please know this doesn't mean you aren't capable. You are absolutely capable of succeeding in organic chemistry with the right help. Now, I'd love to hear how you did in organic chemistry, so leave a comment below. I'm so proud of Ari for pushing herself and recognizing where she can improve. And I'm proud of you for being here and having the courage to do better. Ari's now in organic chemistry too, and by popular demand, Study With Us Season 2 starts now.